Data exchanges happen as data producing systems transmit information to data consuming systems. By data systems, I mean applications, databases, microservices, IoT devices, data warehouses, or data lakes, for example. However, each system has its own way of communicating, its unique communication protocol, data format, or data schema. This complexity makes overall integration challenging and time-consuming to ensure that all systems can communicate together. This is where Kafka comes in as an intermediary to decouple data producers and consumers, to answer the significant challenge with the massive increase in applications and data exchange volume. Apache Kafka is an open-source distributed messaging system based on a publish-subscribe mechanism that facilitates message transmission between message senders and consumers. In essence, Kafka is designed for managing data streams, including collecting data from multiple sources called producers and distributing it to multiple targets called consumers. It can be in real-time, batch, or request-response modes, all at high speed, and we're talking about handling millions of messages per second. Another important concept in Kafka is the notion of events. Reading and writing data in Kafka is done in the form of events, such as a user action on a website, a temperature change, a new financial transaction, and so on. Kafka is implemented as a Kafka cluster, consisting of one or more servers, also called Kafka brokers. The Kafka cluster can horizontally scale by adding additional brokers, enabling it to easily handle large data volumes and high throughput workloads. Data sent to Kafka is retained until a specified retention period expires. Kafka can retain data for extended periods, ranging from hours to days, months, or indefinitely, making it a reliable choice for scenarios where message loss is not acceptable. This persistence allows for message replay in case of processing issues. Kafka organizes messages into categories called topics. Topics are specific streams of data resulting from events and are similar to tables in databases. For example, you might have a commercial transactions topic and another for customer references. These topics consist of partitions. Each partition is ordered, and each message within a partition receives an incremental identifier. Apache Kafka maintains the order of communicated data and the order of message production. Producers publish messages to topics, and consumers subscribe to these topics to receive messages, enabling asynchronous communication. Consumers can read messages from the point they choose. Each partition often has one or more replicas on a few Kafka brokers. In terms of Kafka use cases, it's commonly used as a distributed message bus with the capability to handle millions of messages per second. Kafka is also used for monitoring and debugging purposes, often integrated into data pipelines for centralizing metrics from various applications. It's used for log aggregation, collecting and aggregating logs and metrics from multiple applications. Furthermore, Kafka is primarily used today for data streaming, which involves exchanging data from various sources, especially those generated continuously. It is ideal for applications that require real-time data processing or continuous analysis and response, such as fraud detection, predictive maintenance, machine learning, trading, and various types of big data processing. Kafka serves as a data integration platform for moving data between different systems. It can connect databases, data lakes, and various data sources and destinations, providing a reliable and scalable data pipeline. I hope you enjoyed this video and that it helped you better understand. If that's the case, you can thank me by subscribing to my YouTube channel. See you in the next video.